Chapter 3. Safety first. Accidents are very common nowadays. They happen when we are careless. They cause harm to the life and property. We can avoid the accidents if we follow safety rules at home, at school, in the playground and on the road. Our home provides us safety. We should make it a safe place by being aware and alert all the time. Safety at home. We may suffer from injuries at home by one of the following reasons. Slipping on the floor. If the floor is wet, we can slip. We may also trip over scattered toys or stumble down the stairs. In order to avoid such accidents, we should keep the floors at home clean and dry. Make sure that the bathroom and kitchen floors are not slippery. Keep the toys in their respective place after playing. Use a step ladder or a stool to reach something placed high. Burns. We should take care while handling fire. If not handled carefully, it can kill or injure us. Look at the few ways to prevent fire. Do not keep lighted candles near curtains. Always extinguish a used matchstick before throwing it away. Turn off the gas stove when not in use. Always check them regularly to avoid leakage. Always wear cotton clothes while working in the kitchen. Electric shocks. Electrical appliances should be handled carefully. If you see an electric spark, immediately switch off the main switch. Do not touch an electrical switch or plug with wet hands. Also, make sure that you do not stand on a wet floor without slippers. Always maintain distance from the table fans and heaters if they are on. Poisoning. At home, we use certain items like insecticides, pesticides, detergents, naphthalene balls, etc. that contain harmful chemicals which can be poisonous if consumed. Also, if we consume medicines accidentally, it causes poisoning. The poisonous chemicals should be labeled properly and kept them away from eatables. Medicines should never be taken without the advice of an adult. Safety at school. Accidents can happen in schools when children rush and push each other. To avoid such accidents, never run on the stairs as you may fall. Do not climb on the desk and throw things at each other. Safety in the playground and in the swimming pool. On the playground while playing, always wait for your turn at rides. In the swimming pool, take care that you swim in the presence of an adult. Also use a swimming tube for swimming if you are not an expert swimmer. Safety on the road. We should always follow the safety rules while on the road. Carelessness on the road can cause accidents. To avoid such accidents, while crossing, look to your right, then to your left, and then to your right again to cross the road. Do not drive fast to reach your destination. Instead, start early to avoid panic. Always cross the road at the zebra crossing. First aid. First aid is the immediate help given to an injured person before the medical aid arrives. It aims to avoid any complications that may arise, in turn saving the life of an injured person. While giving first aid, make the injured person comfortable and make him lay down. Do not crowd around him. Common emergencies that need first aid are minor cuts, fainting, insect bites, snake bites, and burns. If bitten by an insect like a bee or a wasp, apply a paste of baking soda and cold cream on the affected part to give relief. Also put some ice on the affected part. If the sting is visible, then go to the doctor to get it removed. If a person faints, make him lay down with his head at a level lower than the body so that the blood flows faster into the brain. Allow fresh air around the person. Sprinkle cold water on his forehead and give him something warm to drink. Then take him to the doctor. For burns, in the case of minor burns, wash the burn area with cold running water. Put an ice pack on the burned area, followed by the application of an antiseptic cream on that area. For minor cuts, in the case of minor cuts, wash the cut with water. After this, apply an antiseptic lotion over it. If there is bleeding from the cut, try to stop it by trying a clean bandage on the cut. Remember that the wound is not exposed to dirt and flies, as they may sit on the wound and cause infection.